Hey, what's up guys? My name is Charlie. Today we're going to be reacting to some more Nostalgia Critic, and it's going to be top 11 cereal mascots. Oh boy, this should be very interesting. I don't know what it's going to be about, but I'm sure it's going to be very interesting because it's by the Nostalgia Critic, of course. So, yeah, let's check out the video, shall we? Let's go.
Hello, I'm the Nostalgia Critic. I remember it, so you don't have to.
Oh god.
I can't help it. I'm a product of advertising. I see something advertised, I have to go buy it.
Buy this.
But that doesn't mean there aren't some advertising gimmicks or characters that work better than others.
Buy this one too.
Take, for example, cereal labels. There are dozens of
cereals out there,
but only a distinct few seem to survive over the years. Is it really the taste of the cereal that keeps kids coming back, or is it the mascots? The timeless characters that go through many changes but still keep the same likability over the decades.
Good question.
No, it's obviously the taste. But yeah, the mascots play a big role. And that's why I'm counting down the top 11 best sugar-coated marketing icons of all time. Why top 11? Because I like to go one step beyond. So, sit back and enjoy the top 11 greatest cereal mascots.
What the hell is it? Oh, Tony the Tiger, wasn't it? Oh, I can't remember. He does Frosties. Oh, boy. Look at that. Alright, top 11 cereal mascots. Let's see what he has to offer.
Number 11.
Number 11.
Toucan Sam from Fruit
Toucan
Loops.
Sam.
Released
Fruit
in around 1945, Toucan Sam started off with a relatively boring scenario, just talking in Pig Latin.
Crispy and delicious day for breakfast or for egging snake.
Riveting.
Smart kid.
By the way, that voice sounds different to you. That's because it wasn't always done by the same person. In fact, that's actually Mel Blanc, the voice of most of the Looney Tunes characters.
Damn.
But they didn't feel like the character was strong enough, so they switched out the voices with Paul Frees, another actor who might sound familiar.
So look for Kellogg's Fruit Loops. Follow your nose.
Did you hear that note?
Yes, it's the same guy who did Ludwig von Drake. That's kind of cool.
Damn.
They also changed the scenario.
I don't think we have Fruit Loops.
Usually starts off with somebody having a problem or searching for something. No matter what the dialogue,
I haven't seen
Fruit Loops.
Loops
always seems to have the answer.
They left without breakfast again.
I've been a trick for days and I'm tired of frozen breakfast.
I need a really ride breakfast.
Yeah, I don't think they have Fruit Loops. Where I am.
Follow my nose. Kellogg's Fruit Loops cereal.
Just how many problems can Fruit Loops change anyway? Toucan Sam, my father has AIDS.
Then follow your nose.
Well, okay.
It always knows.
Oh, I wonder what it could be.
Kellogg's Fruit Loops cereal.
I don't think I've ever had Fruit Loops either.
My father still has AIDS.
Yeah. Okay.
Well, whatever the issue, there was always a big bowl of Fruit Loops cereal there to make you forget about all your problems. Or at least, try to make you forget.
Yeah. I've had Cheerios, but I don't think I've ever had Fruit Loops. Number 10.
Cookie Crook and Officer Crumb.
Now, oh boy, I don't think I've seen
this. Aren't around anymore, but I wanted to list them just to show the evolution of a character. Originally released in 1977, the mascot for Cookie Crisp was originally a wizard named Jarvis. Isn't that a weird name?
Damn.
His gimmick was to turn cereal bowls into big pots of cookies. You know, because
it was like the character from Sword in the Stone.
Didn't catch on very well, so they changed it in 1985 to a disruptive pair called Cookie Crook and Officer Crumb. This caught on much better, but it still wasn't gimmicky enough. If only there was an annoying catchphrase that every kid could be shouting obnoxiously.
Cookie Crisp.
So they gave the Cookie Crook a dog named Chip, who would ruin everything by always shouting,
Cookie Crisp.
That did even better. So after a while, they just said, fuck the cops and robbers, let's just make it about the dog. So the dog was a mascot for a while.
Oh, with a mouthful of chips in every bite.
But they didn't think the design was hip enough for the young kids. So they decided to redesign it and make it into a...
What do kids know about being hip? Come on.
And made the change complete by giving him a sports jacket.
Old people make what's hip, not young people.
You can't see the natural evolution of going from a Merlin-style wizard into a sports-centered husky?
Who'd you think made
someone
hip
needs to take some
adults?
For all the changes it went through, the Cookie Crook and Cop were the best additions. Because hey, who doesn't love a good game of cops and robbers? Well, okay, cops and robbers, but still, it was a good idea. Lasting almost 8 years in commercials. That's one tough cookie that's hard to beat.
Cookie Crisp. Cookie Crisp. Oh boy.
Good part of this complete breakfast.
Number 9.
Double 9. Okay.
The Honey Nut Cheerios Bee.
the Honey Nut Cheerios. Oh boy.
This movie was certainly enjoyable to watch, making any real-life bees look like fucking monsters. His gimmick was to try and get people.
I had some Honey Cheerios
soup,
last week, actually. But not Honey Nut Cheerios, just Honey Cheerios. I think they removed the nuts because people are allergic to them.
Nuts and honey.
Did you say hookers and blow? Oh no, you said honey and nuts. That's not nearly as good.
Oh boy.
Actually, I always like watching this commercial in particular around Christmas time. That and the Fruity Pebbles commercial with Santa. And
oh,
no,
Fruity
not
Pebbles.
They're not going to make it on the countdown because they're already on a show.
It's never
like
had Fruity
Jack
Pebbles
Sparrow
either.
On the list because of the Pirates of the Caribbean cereal. It just doesn't seem right. That and they promote smoking. Dude, that's just wrong. It's funny that we all just call him B because he actually was given a name. In 2000, they held a contest for who would name the Honey Nut Cheerios B, and a fifth grader won the prize by naming him, are you ready for this, Buzz B. Really?
That's the most but like Buzz Lightyear or something?
Well, while you're at it, why don't you just call these characters Squeak Mouse, Fly Bird, or Shit Spewer? The possibilities are just endless. Well, to me, he's the Honey Nut Cheerios B. Sure, it's a long name, but a mascot by any other name would still be as marketable. Or should I say, be marketable.
Ugh, come on. So cheesy.
No, that'd be silly. It'd be stretching out the middle of a word for no reason. Number 8.
Number 8.
Wendell from Cinnamon Toast Crunch.
Cinnamon Toast Crunch.
Cinnamon Toast Crunch.
I don't think I've ever had
Wendell,
that.
But actually two other chefs. What were their names?
Nobody knows.
And nobody cares.
In fact, Wendell is the only one who ever had a name and identity out of these three. Isn't that a little strange? Mm. They were a trio for a while until this one commercial had Wendell suck himself into a television because he was distracted by the Cinnamon Toast Crunch that was on the TV.
Wendell's girl Cinnamon's crunchy crazy!
Which is odd because he makes the stuff and he's surrounded by it. Isn't that kind of like watching porn when you own a bordello? The other chefs got him back, but the gimmick was now changed. Now the scenario was Wendell would go crazy every time he saw Cinnamon Toast Crunch and would immediately go after it.
Damn.
Where did the other two chefs go?
It's a Cinnamon Toast addict.
My guess is Wendell had them assassinated. Somewhere at the bottom of the ocean, you'll find two chefs with cement shoes and a cookie crook next to a cookie cup. They have to go somewhere! Since then, the focus seemed to veer away from Wendell and instead showed off other people who could see everything except why kids love Cinnamon Toast Crunch.
But does yeah, he know why kids I've heard of Cinnamon Toast Crunch, but I've never had it.
I just don't know.
I don't
well,
like cinnamon,
isn't it
so...
It's covered in crack. The sugar's just a cover. That's pure 100% blow. Haven't you ever wondered why your kids get so active after they eat it? Whatever does go into those crystals, you can always be sure that there's a creepy old man who's there to make it.
Mm. A tasty part of a complete breakfast.
Yeah, bizarre.
Number 7.
Number 7.
Lucky, from Lucky Charms.
Oh, Lucky Charms.
Not so much has changed with him over the years. Literally from day one, the gimmick has always been the same. Catch Lucky, and you get his Lucky Charms.
Boy.
Free shamrocks. Catch a pack of Lucky Charms.
Okay, what the hell's the kid doing with handcuffs? Getting his start in 1962, Lucky was originally known as LC Leprechaun. Well, what did the LC stand
for? Yeah, I remember Lucky Charms from the Leprechaun movies.
Yeah, I'm a fucking...
believe David Warwick was in it or something like that? Warwick David or something like that? Davis Warwick? Can't remember the name, but played a lot of...
Love chasing after things, so the idea of trying to catch something to get reward is always foolproof.
He was in Hitchhiker's Guide of the Galaxy, I believe.
But would you be pissed off if you caught a leprechaun and instead of gold he got a friggin' bowl of cereal?
And he was in Willow as well.
Now that you caught me, you
and Harry
me
Potter.
Lucky Charms!
No, I want the gold.
No,
and he was in the labyrinth, I believe.
No, I want the gold.
No, you want a Lucky Charms.
I'm quite positive I want the gold.
Well, if you want to deny
and
the
I knew he was in Star Wars.
Of...
Just want to note that.
Like that.
Whereas, yeah. Oh, damn.
An idea so basic it has to be admired, Lucky is the perfect prize to catch or smash at the end of any rainbow.
All right, number 6.
Captain Crunch from, well,
Captain Crunch, of course.
Is it me, or is this guy the Snaggle?
Never had Captain Crunch reaver. Jesus.
Crunch with Crunchberries. Next time, let's not wish quite so hard.
And remember to exit. Stage right.
I don't eat a lot of these cereals, do I? Damn.
That started out with an entire cast.
Surprise.
There was a dog, four annoying kids, and an evil pirate named LaFoot.
I normally have cornflakes. That's it.
Soggies, these big puddles of splooge with eyes that like to make everything,
Cocoa Pops, cornflakes, Weetabix, shredded wheat,
evil machine that led the Soggies, but I can't Cheerios. Really remember his name. This scenario would have been fine and good, except that they actually turned it into a straight-up war. I mean, it was like a soap opera with guns, oh, spaceships, giant robots, kind of get out of control.
I feel like they're...
This is a job for Crunch Power.
Like they're trying to sell toys.
We're afraid of those Soggies.
Now, let's move on to waterboarding them. I'm not sure if the Soggies are still around, but the captain sure is. In fact, they even revealed his entire name at one point, calling him Captain Horatio Magellan Crunch.
Damn.
Because every kid would remember that name.
Yeah.
Couldn't you call him Joe?
Yeah, Jesus.
Always
easy.
Crunchy, never soggy. Captain Crunch still remains the captain that can make it happen.
Let's go, Sea Dog. I hate to see a grown pirate cry.
Number five,
here we go.
Count Chocula from Count Chocula.
What?
Speaking from a health point of view, what's worse than marshmallows in your cereal? How about chocolate marshmallows in chocolate cereal?
Damn.
Why don't you just throw in miniature cheeseburgers while you're at it? Well, as horrible as it is for you, it tasted great. And it had a great mascot.
I've heard about this cereal,
so
actually.
That there were actually cereal spin-offs. Mm. That's ironic, because the more healthy they got, the less successful they did. Like Frankenberry's still sort of around, Blueberry you barely see. And who the hell even remembers Fruity Yummy Mummy? What, was Vegetable Lactor too good a name to take?
Oh, boy.
Well, we still love the characters. It was kind of clever that they always took the voice of the movie monster they were spoofing. Like Count Chocula's Bela Lugosi.
And you'll enjoy my Count Chocula cereal.
Frankenberry's Boris Karloff.
Frankenberry has strawberry-flavored sweeties.
And for some reason, Blueberry was Peter Lorre.
With my heart.
Peter Lorre? Wow.
Did he ever play a ghost? Oh, well, he's dead now, so maybe that counts.
You can bounce
it. Either way, it.
It
was Count Chocula that brought in the big bucks. Not the healthiest cereal, but hey, that's why we loved it so much.
How about that monster for breakfast today?
Oh boy. Alright, number four.
Sonny from Cocoa Puffs. Sonny is just an addict, okay? He needs help. He needs to go into rehab and have his illness treated. Look at him. He's just trying to do his everyday work when suddenly these little bungholes come up and tempt him by feeding his habit. What's up with those kids? They're fucking enablers.
He's a cocoa addict. He's an addict. Probably. He's gonna sniff it up his nose.
Right there, man. Yeah, crystal puffs. Get your nice and saucy fucked up. But yeah. Don't blame the kids. Blame his grandpa, who started out pushing the stuff back in the 60s.
I'll speed things up, cause Sonny can't resist Cocoa Puffs.
He would do this in every commercial. What a dick!
Feeding his addiction.
I'm assuming died from some sort of overdose. Mm. Sonny was left on his own to fight his inner demons every day for the rest of his life.
Damn.
Cocoa Puffs. Poor soul. We may never know what he's like as a sober bird.
I have Cocoa Puffs, but
do you know who originally did the voice for Sonny? You will never guess in a million years.
Who?
Get crabs for me! Free and Cocoa Puffs!
Oh, you gotta be joking.
That's right, it's the guy who did Lion-O from Thundercats.
Wow.
What the hell happens to a guy who goes from a butch manly superhero to a crazy addicted bird?
Damn, he needed his money.
Puffs happens! Everyone thinks Lindsay Lohan got addicted to drugs? Not a joke. It was Puffs! Tennessee Williams addicted to alcohol? Not even close. It was Puffs! 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 Puffs!
Slap Britney Spears on the list.
Life may be rough, but don't do Puffs.
It isn't glamorous or cool, but kid stuff.
Yep, listen to Pee Wee Herman. Didn't Pee Wee Herman is an alcoholic? Wasn't he a druggie as well? Number three.
Sugar Bear from Golden Quiz.
Sugar Bear.
I love this guy. This is the most laid-back character who always somehow manages to kick ass.
Put the pole in the bowl.
He's like if the dude was on steroids. He's freaking awesome.
I can't get enough Super Golden Crisp. It's got the crunch with punch.
He surprisingly started out on a show called Linus the Lionhearted, who actually hosted a slew of characters that had their own cereals. Did you see him? Did you see him? Watch it again. How funny is that? All these overblown characters, and the one that makes it big is the very last one. I don't know if he did well because of the cereal, or if the cereal did well because of him, but he stuck around. And like most cereals, Golden Crisp, then called Sugar Crisp, seemed to be the one entity that could solve all the world's problems.
Damn. Hey, Blob, you're pulling the air.
I don't care, Bear.
Well, I do. So I'll put out the fire and clear up the air.
Take that, Al Gore!
Wow.
You deserve a reward, Sugar.
Ooh. Super Sugar Crisp is my reward.
Yeah, he's just like, fuck off, bitch. I got some cereal.
Yeah, I'll take another reward if I had that opportunity.
Eventually, the story became that all these evil baddies would try to steal his Golden Crisp.
What's up, fellas?
Your ties are bad with Cruiser for Quad!
What the fuck are those?
He popped a few in his mouth, he became like Popeye and kicked
ass. Yes, that snake's bite is history.
Yeah, I can't get enough of me, Golden Crisp.
Everybody's falling for that great honey crunch again.
This is really bizarre.
Plot involved where he constantly tries to steal Golden Crisp from an old lady. Isn't that a little... low?
Here comes that singing bear again to steal my post Sugar Crisp cereal.
It's a cereal commercial, not a bloody...
Well, there's anyone that can make robbing from the elderly
TV
cool.
Series.
Always smooth, always laid back, and always pat.
You can't get enough Super Golden Crisp. It's got the crunch with touch.
The animation's really good, though. You gotta admit.
Number two.
Oh boy, here we
the
go.
The Trix Rabbit from Trix.
The Trix Rabbit.
Is like
heard of it,
Greek
but never had
tragedy.
It.
Along with Oedipus and Antigone, the Trix Rabbit will always be remembered as a great tragic figure. All he wants is Trix, just a simple little cereal that he decided to devote his entire life to. But will the kids ever give him the damn stuff? No! And why?
Trix are for kids.
Because they're fucking assholes, that's why. It's like the natural order of things. The world goes around, the sun always comes up, and the Trix Rabbit must suffer. How horribly cruel!
Oh, the poor rabbit.
Don't tell me.
What did he ever
poor
do
thing.
To any other human being?
Yeah.
Just cut him a break.
Yeah, give him his fucking cereal.
I'm gonna get to eat Trix.
Look, even Santa steals from him. What a jolly old prick.
Wow. What about the
even
gift
with
of giving?
Even Bugs Bunny, he could never seem to get any.
Have I got a disguise for you? Make that bunny.
Silly rabbit.
I'd prefer a happy ending.
That's pretty bad when even bugs can't
thing.
Stand to watch your misery. There's even this one commercial I love where you think he's finally gonna get it.
After all these years of Trix for Kids, well, they're for rabbits!
Oh, boy.
Bastards! So
got
I guess
milk.
The Trix Rabbit is a way of showing kids.
God, that turned into something really dull, didn't it? When
it's
I heard
right,
that phrase.
It's not fair, but you gotta just deal with it.
Got milk.
Tricks are for kids, motherfucker.
That's a dirty phrase he says.
Because hey, we're just flat out sadists.
It was innocent back then, but not now.
And the number one greatest cereal mascot is.
Number
Tony
one.
The Tiger.
Tony the Tiger, of course.
This is the
I have
icon we
Frosty
all
sort
to
of
be.
Time.
The sports star. The guy that said, if you just eat my sugar-coated crusty paper, you'll be unstoppable like me.
Good, there, great.
How can you not like this guy? He's strong, he's athletic, and has a clean personality, unlike some of the other addicts on this countdown. Every ad seemed the same. You got some kid who was being made fun of before the big game.
Hey kid, good shot yesterday!
Come on, see if you're any good!
You two up for a little game?
Wanna take a horsey ride?
Hey, Wimp! I heard that you cried when your mother got slaughtered by your drunken father!
Damn.
But then Tony's frosted flake seems to give the kid the extra energy that he or she needs. Who let the tiger out of the cage?
Yeah. Put the tiger in a cage, Jesus.
Frosted flakes, the middle finger of breakfast. Actually, Tony started out in 1958 and even had
Damn.
A son named Tony Jr.
Wow. Oh yeah, I remember Tony.
By Kellogg's out of Battle Creek.
His voice was different, too. It was done by Dallas McKennon, who you may recognize from that Haunted Mansion ride.
Oh boy, I've heard this, yeah.
Bear
Then the voice was continued by Thurl Ravenscroft, who sang a lot of the songs from How the Grinch Stole Christmas.
Mm. You show him, but first let's start with a complete breakfast, including my Frosted Flakes.
But after his death in 2005, they gave the job to Lee Marshall, who's still doing it today.
Go, Tiger!
He was the only cereal mascot who actually kind of seemed like a role model. He was cool, strong, and just a character you could look up to.
All yours, Tiger!
It's a cereal brand, not a... This certainly happened to me before.
If you didn't like him, then you're a raving douchebag! And those are the top 11 greatest cereal mascots. I hope you enjoyed them. And before I go, I'd like to acknowledge all of the poor souls who sadly lost their lives to the addiction that is Cocoa Puffs.
Oh boy, snorting too much of that Cocoa Puffs. Jimi Hendrix, God. Oh boy. Abraham Lincoln? SpongeBob SquarePants. We're the passengers of the... Oh boy.
I'm the nostalgia critic. I remember it, so you don't have to.
Let's put the Terminator music. Oh boy, well there you go. I never thought I was gonna watch a 20-minute advertisement video about bloody cereal. Oh, that was very bizarre. But I remember Frosty, I mean all the cereal I've had, I remember most of these cereals that he's demonstrated in the video, well displayed so to speak. And I've had some of the cereal, like the Frosties and stuff like that, and I've heard of some of the cereal, but I've never had. I've never had Fruit Loops, Captain Crunch, that cinnamon cereal, and just that, what was it, that Vampire Cocoa Puffs or something like that. I've never had any of that before. I'm sure some of them not in production anymore, maybe. But I've never had all that sort of cereal, Fruit Loops and stuff like that, Fruity Pebbles, and I don't know. I grew up with Frosted Flakes, I normally have Weetabix, and Shredded Wheat. I don't know if you know what Shredded Wheat is, but I have stuff like that. I mean, with cereal is weird because sometimes you don't get cereal is a different. You get sort of different cereals and countries and stuff like that. So, yeah. I mean, the Frosted Flakes, I would go for every single time because they're just absolutely, they're great. I'm sorry, I just had to do that. Oh, that was bad. I'm so sorry. I couldn't resist. Yeah, from what I remember, there was a lot of controversy with the Frosted Flakes one, Tony the Tiger, because they released a commercial and an advert, so to speak. And there was a kid singing in high school or something like that. It was like, they're gonna taste great. And my God, that was one of the most hated adverts on TV there could be. I heard that kid got bullied a lot for making that Frosties advert. From people who know what I'm talking about, just search Frosties kid. Just search that in, and that kid got a lot of slack. Not a lot of slack, a lot of beating, so to speak. He did not get a break. A lot of people roasted him. He's probably still getting roasted today in 2019. From what I remember, watching that commercial, that advertisement on TV, it just pissed everybody off, that commercial, so to speak. It was just absolutely horrible. He was just an actor. He was doing a job, you know. He was doing it for the paycheck. But it was just so, so cringy. It just rubbed people the wrong way. I remember watching it, and I was cringing when I watched it. It's like nothing you've ever seen before. It was just cringe. Sometimes it's trendy to hate people. if you know what I'm talking about, the Frosties kid, you remember watching that commercial or advertisement, and my God, my god, that was a horrible one to watch. But I hope he's happy, probably not suffering from depression from all the bullying. I hope he's living a happy life. I hope he's putting that good money to good use to a college education or something. You know, we gotta start somewhere. We've all gotta start somewhere, and that kid had to start somewhere. I'm sure he's gonna be an actor one day. I don't know. Who knows? If you like this video, make sure to give a like, comment down below, and make sure to subscribe to my channel if you enjoy my content. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.